Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to learn about how to write the nomenclature of alcohols, phenols and ethers. So in order to write the nomenclature of any compounds, we must have certain information with us. That is, we need to identify the parent chain or the longest hydrocarbon. We need to identify the principal functional group or the suffix, which will become the suffix of the name. We also need to identify the substituents and its position, because they form the prefix of the name. Here we are already familiar with the priority series of various functional groups. Now, here we have summarized, or here we have a table in which we have various structures, their common names and IUPAC name. It is very important that along with the IUPAC name, we must remember at least these common names of the structures given here, because they are used very commonly in organic chemistry. For example, here CH3CH2CH2OH is nothing but N-propyl alcohol. And here we have CH3CHOHCH3, this becomes isopropyl alcohol, which is nothing but propen-2-ol, because OH is its second carbon. Now here we have CH3CHOHCH2CH3, this structure corresponds to the common name sec-butyl alcohol. And here we have CH3CHCH3CH2OH, again this is nothing but isobutyl. This particular group is nothing but CH3CHCH3 is isobutyl alcohol, because here we have 4 carbon atoms. And here CH3CCH3CH3, or when methyl, 2 methyl groups are attached to this carbon atom, or this particular structure corresponds to the common name tert-butyl alcohol. Again, I repeat, you must remember the common names of these structures, because they come repeatedly throughout organic chemistry. Now, we can also look at the common names of few phenol compounds here, or phenol substituted compounds. Here we have phenol, and when we have an OH group, or when we have a CH3 group attached to phenol, in that case we call that particular compound as a common name chrysol. Now, depending on the position of CH3, the methyl and OH group, it can be ortho, meta or para. We can also see that when two OH groups are attached to a benzene ring, depending on the position or the relative position of these OH groups with each other, we have different common names. For example, in catechol, you can see that the OH groups are ortho to each other. In resorcinol, we can see that the OH groups are meta to each other. And in hydroquinone or quinone, we can see that the OH groups are para to each other. The IUPAC name would be very simple. Here we have benzene 1,2-diol, here benzene 1,3-diol, and this would be simply benzene 1,4-diol. Let us now see how to write the nomenclature of ethers. So in this case, what we do is that the larger hydrocarbon is considered the parent chain. And as you can already see, in symmetrical ethers, we add the word di before writing the name of the ether. For example, here we have CH3OCH3, this is a symmetrical ether, and we have two methyl groups, and therefore the common name would be dimethyl ether, and the IUPAC name would be methoxymethane, because OCH3 is methoxy and your parent chain or parent group is nothing but methyl. So this would be methoxymethane. Now here we have an unsymmetrical ether, and in this case the common name would be methyl N-propyl ether. And IUPAC name would be 1-methoxypropane. Again, why? Because propane is the larger hydrocarbon, and therefore that becomes a parent chain, and the substituent would be simply 1-methoxypropane. Now again, if you look at this particular compound, C6H5OCH3, the common name is methyl phenyl ether, and if you look at the IUPAC name, this is nothing but 1-methoxybenzene, because benzene is a larger hydrocarbon and will therefore become the parent chain. Note that this particular compound, that is 1-methoxybenzene, is also called anisole. Now going to the last structure, you have CH3OCHCH3CH3. This is nothing but methyl isopropyl ether, because this is nothing but the isopropyl group, and the IUPAC name would be simply 2-methoxypropane, because propane CH3CHCH3 is the larger hydrocarbon, this will become the parent chain, and the substitution is its second carbon, 1, 2, 3, it's its second carbon, and therefore it becomes 2-methoxypropane. Now let's try to understand this by discussing a few problems. So in the first problem, we have a structure like this, And we know that according to the rules of IUPAC nomenclature, our parent chain should contain the principal functional group and should have the lowest numbering. So therefore, you have two substituents here, OH and Cl, and from the priority series, we know that OH has higher priority than Cl. Therefore, OH becomes the principal functional group. Let's try to number this now. So numbering would be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we can see that the base compound is nothing but pentanol or pentane 1-ol, because OH is at the first carbon atom. And you have two substituents. You have a substitution at second carbon atom and you have a substitution at third carbon atom. Now the substituents are written based on their alphabetical precedence. Therefore, you can see that the IUPAC name of the structure is nothing but 3-chloromethyl-2-isopropyl-pentan-1-ol. Because chloromethyl precedes isopropyl alphabetically, and we are already familiar with this group. CH3 is nothing but isopropyl group, and this is nothing but chloromethyl CH2Cl. Let's look at the second structure. Here again, if you try to write the IUPAC name, you can see that the numbering is done in such a way that the functional group receives the lowest number. Therefore, numbering would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can see that our parent hydrocarbon is nothing but a hexane, and you have OH at 3 position. Therefore, this would be hex 1-ene-3-ol, where 3 corresponds to the position of OH and 1 corresponds to the position of the double bond. Let's look at the next structure. Here we have CH3CCH3 double bond CBr CH2OH. Again, we are very familiar with how to write the IUPAC names by now. So, writing the number, you can see that the numbering would be this way, and you have substitution at C2 and C3. So, writing the substituents in alphabetical order, we can see that the IUPAC name of this given structure is nothing but 2-bromo-3-methyl-but-2-ene-1-ol. Again, 1 corresponds to the position of the hydroxy group and 2 corresponds to the position of the double bond. Let's now look at the last structure. Here we have a cyclohexyl group and you have OH and Br attached at these positions. Therefore, writing the IUPAC name of this structure is very simple, which is nothing but 3-bromo-cyclohexanol. I hope you are very clear on how to write the IUPAC names of alcohols, phenols and ethers. Thank you.